वेलकम टू अरविंद सिंह एकेडमी एंड नल टूल. दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 13. आई होप इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट डेफिनेट इंटीग्रेशन. सो डेफिनेट इंटीग्रेशन एंड सो लेट अस स्टार्ट डेफिनेट इंटीग्रल्स. सो डेफिनेट इंटीग्रल्स वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डेफिनेट इंटीग्रल. व्हाई दिस इज कॉल्ड डेफिनेट इंटीग्रल? देयर इज फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन व्हिच मस्ट कम इन योर माइंड. So if y is equal to fx be any function, y is equal to fx be any function, then integration of the form a to b fx dx, fx is a function, is something which will come, say fx, capital fx, here written something different function will come, a to b, and then here function will be fb minus fa. That is a fixed value. And therefore, definite value, we will get a definite value. There is no c here, definite value, and hence this is called definite integral. Because we get definite value, so we can have definite integral. So, in definite integral, what is that? If I am writing that integration of, what is geometrical meaning of this? Try to understand. If I am writing this, y-axis, this is x-axis, and this is an origin. And if I draw two perpendicular lines from here, this is say x is equal to a, and that one is x is equal to b. So what will happen? X, if I write here fx dx, that is integral y dx, then it will give this area inclusive is equal to a and x is equal to b. So, a to b y dx is the area enclosed between curve and x axis between two lines. X is equal to a and x is equal to b. X is equal to a and x is equal to b. Since this is a definite area, then that is why it is called definite integral. So here we will use this concept, and wherever it is required, we will write also. So the basic thing is that, suppose I have, let us consider some questions. Here sine x, we have to find integration of sine x from 0 to pi by 2 dx. The integration of sine x, limit of sine x is minus cos x, and the limit of integration is 0 to pi by 2. Here pi by 2 is called upper limit and 0 is called lower limit. So I can write here pi by 2 and minus is taken outer side and cos 0. So what will happen? Minus cos pi by 2 is 0 and cos 0 is 1. So minus minus plus 1. This is a fixed value. So that is why it is called definite integral. I hope you got this point right now. Here, remember this. In a to b, where a is called lower limit of integration, and b is called upper limit of integration. Upper limit of integration, right? Of integration in, okay. So similar things you have to, what you learn in indefinite integral, that you have to use here also. And let us consider another question, that is 3x square plus 5x minus 1, and limit of integration is 1 to 2. Then you can also do a integrate first, that is 3 x square integration is x cube by 3 plus 5 x integration is x square by 2, integration of 1 is x, and then you can take 1 to 2, 3, 3 cancel. So that can be written as in place of x I can put upper limit, that is 2 cube plus 5 into 2 square by 2 minus 2 and minus then lower limit. So this is 1 cube plus 5 into 1 square by 2 minus 1. So the things will come like, say, this is 2 cube, that is 8, plus 2 and 2 cancel, 5 2 are 10, minus 2, and again this will be 1 plus 1 plus 5 by 2 minus 1, this 1 1 cancel, that is 5 by 2. So that will be 10 minus 2 8 plus 8 16, 16 minus 5 by 2, that is 32 minus 5, 27 by 2 unit. This is answer, right? So here fixed value will come definitely, and whether it is an algebraic function or trigonometric function or exponential function, for all kind of functions you can do that. Let us consider another question, that 1 2 3 e to the power x plus 2 dx. So here integration of e to the power x is e to the power x, and coefficient of x is 1, so we can even use it like e to the power x plus 2, the same thing will come. And integration is same, and putting the value of upper limit, that is e to the power 5, 3 plus 2 5, minus k, again if you put 1, then e to the power 3, that is e to the power 3, if you take common, e square minus 1, that will be the answer. So whether it is an exponential function, questions, if there is a 4 to 8 log of x to the base x dx, then you can go with the substitutions as well, or 1 by x, say, simply, just let me write here, a simple question can have 1 by x, integration of 1 by x is log x, and now this is 4 and this is 8, so we can write log 8 minus log 4, and log m minus log n is log m by n, so 8 by 4, that is log 2. So answer is log 2. So wherever there is a question of this category, we can use it, right? Now there is no problem at all. And if you want to find questions like this, sin x plus cos x plus 3 like this, and integration from 0 to pi, say like this, dx, then what will happen? Sin x, integration of sin x is cos x, right? Now sin x is minus cos x, and cos x is sin x, and 3 is 3x. Now we can put it 0 to pi. So we can do it one by one, right? Now not necessary that all the value of is equal to pi to be taken first and thereafter 0. You can do it individually. For example, if I can minus of cos pi minus cos 0, you can do like this also. Plus for sine, this is sin pi minus sin 0, right? Now minus 1, and cos 0 is 1, so that will be minus 2 multiplied by minus is 2. Sin pi is 0 and sin 0 is 0, so that is 0, and 3 into pi, that is 3 pi, so that will be answer. So I hope you got it. Now some questions may be containing the substitutions, and how when to change the limit of substitution, that I would like to tell you. For example, if I have 0 to pi and cos 4x sin x dx, say like this, and we have to integrate them. So without substitution, it is difficult to go ahead. So we can put substitutions. And what are the type of substitutions we need to put? Put cos x is equal to t. So dy dx of cos x is dy dx of cos x is dy dt of dx. So derivative of cos x is minus sin x dx, this dx will come this side, is equal to dt. So we can write here, therefore sin x dx is equal to minus dt, we can write. Now we have to change limit as well, because we choose, so we have to change limit. Because this limit dx, this is for value of x, as I told you, integral dx means operator is dx. So here x is equal to a and x is equal to b, these are the two lines. So this is a value of x, but it is not value of t. So we have to put substitutions, and then correspondingly you have to find the value of another variable which you have substituted, that is here t. So when x is equal to, how to change limit? This is a question. Change of limit. So change of limit. Now change of limit is required. Change of limit is required. Remember. is required whenever substitution takes place. Whenever substitution takes place, remember this, takes place, right now. So change of limit is required, remember. So how to change this limit? Put x is equal to, first lower limit is 0. So when x is equal to 0, cos 0 is t in place of x. So cos 0 is 1, therefore t is equal to 1. When x is equal to pi, then what will happen? If I will put x is equal to pi, or if I take limit of integration as pi by 2, say, so if even pi can be also taken, but pi by 2 I have taken, so that will be cos pi by 2 is equal to t, it means t is equal to 0. So t is equal to 0. When x was 0, then corresponding value of t is 1. When x is pi by 2, then corresponding value of t is 0. So what was the limit from 0 to pi by 2? That now turn up as 1 to 0. So integration can be now takes place like here. Therefore, just to explain this. Therefore, integration right here. Let me write here. Therefore, integration is equal to limit will be 0 to, instead of 0 to pi by 2, that will be 1 to 0. Cos 4x, cos x is t, so cos 4x is t to the power 4. Sin x dx is nothing else. This sin x dx is nothing else, but this sin x dx is minus dt. So, where you can write minus dt. Minus will come here, minus will be taken outside. This is 1 to 0 t to the power 4 dt, and that will be t to the power 5 by 5. Integration is from 1 to 0. That is 1 to 0. 1 to 0. So if you put value of 0, then 0 to the power 5 is 0 by 5 is 0. So that will be 0. And if you put 1, then this will be 1 by 5. Square unit, right? Now square unit, why I am writing a square unit? Because it will give the area, always it will give area. So square unit, that will be the answer. So you can, wherever there is a substitution, you have to change the limit accordingly. That the basic things you need to understand, and I hope you got it. Sometimes during integration by part, how to put the value of limit, that is very crucial things. Usually students are not able to get this. So let me explain this one also. Say, if I have integration of 1 to 2 and x log x is a question, and this is what? So as per this concept, what we have learned, ILET, logarithm is come first and algebraic is second. So integrating by part, first function as it is, that is log x. Integration of second, that is x square by 2, and limit of integration will be 1 to 2 minus limit of integration is 1 to 2 still, and derivative of first, that is log x. Log x derivative of log x is 1 by x. Integration of second, that is x square by 2. Whenever sign of integration will be finally removed, then only you need to put the value of limit, otherwise no need to put the value. So here, if I'll put 2, then this will be 2 square by 2, that is 4 by 2, that is 2. So 2 log of, and in place of x, that is 2. If I put 1, then it will be 1 by 2 log 1, and log 1 is 0. So finally, thing will be 0 here. Minus x and x cancel, x by 2. So 1 by 2 is outside, x will remain inside, 1 to 2 again. So remember this. This will comes like 2 log 2 minus 1 by 2, and if you put the value 2, then 2 square by 2, that is 2, minus if I put 1, then this will be 1 by 2. This is the value. So 2 minus 1 is 3 by 2. So the answer will come here, 2 log 2, and this is 3 by 2, right now? 3 by 2 multiply by 1 by 2 is 3 by 4. And so minus 3 by 4, that would be the answer. So you can put this value as well, whenever integration by part is there, and there is also limit, so you can use it, and by integration by part, put the limit like this also. So I hope you understood all these things, right now. And let us solve one question, some properties also, some properties of definite integral, properties. Although this is not, but still, I am dealing with this some properties, some useful properties are there, which may be used during physics, derivation of any function. So these are some basic one, that integral of a to b fx dx is equal to integral of a to, because finally the answer of a question will depend on the value of limit, because finally what we are doing, we are putting the value of limit, right now, and not the function. For example, if I have integration, just let me explain this. Here I am giving the idea that how to deal with this. Right. Say I have integration of 0 to pi by 2 sin x dx. Then integration is minus cos x, and what is that? 0 to pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is 0, minus cos 0 is 1. So that will be minus of 0 minus 1, that is 1 finally. If I have another function, say instead of sin x, there is sin y and dy. Then also the integration is minus cos y to pi by 2 sin y dy. Then integration is minus cos y, and again the limit of integration is 0 to pi by 2. So you will put minus cos pi by 2 minus cos 0 in similar way. That will be 0 to pi by 2. So what will happen? That will be cos pi by 2 is 0 and cos 0 is 1. So that will be minus of 0 minus 1, and what is that? 1. So here, whether it is a sin x dx or sin y dy, both have, right? And now there is another property which is said to be a to b fx dx is equal to, there is some other properties as well, to b fx dx is equal to minus of b to a fx dx. If limit of integration will change, then there will be what negative sign will come. And the third important property which will be used again, that is a to b fx dx is equal to a to c fx dx plus c to b fx dx, where c lies between a and b. So we can break the limit. These are three useful properties, although there are some many more properties are there, but these are three useful properties which will be applicable in physics. And I am not telling you anything extra which will be not useful in physics, but just for sake of knowledge, because you will learn all these things in mathematics as well. So here this, as I told you, that the area is obtained in integration. So sometimes application is like this. Find, question is there, find the area enclosed by line y is equal to 3x plus 4 between x is equal to 3, right? So if I have this question, then how to deal? So first of all, we should plot the graph of this function, isn't it? Solution, graph of this function. So if I'll plot the graph, just for explaining this, that there we should plot the graph of the function, and thereafter we will write this, the answer, just to explain this. If I am writing here like this, see, this one is x axis, y axis, and the line is y is equal to 3x plus 4. Y is 3x plus 4. So in that case, the line is like this. Right? Say line is like this. So this is x axis, this one is y axis, this is say x dash, this is y dash, and this is a line. What is line? Y is equal to 3x plus 4. So y intercept, this is 4. This is 4. And this 4 comma 4. Now we have to find two lines between x is equal to a and x is equal to 3. So x is equal to 1, say a is there, x is equal to 1, and x is equal to 3 is there. Write one more line, say x is equal to 3 is there. If I write here, as it is given that here the area y is equal to 3x plus, and we have to plot the area between x is equal to 1 and x is equal to 3. Means this area you need to calculate. You have to calculate this area, right? So just wait. Let me set this. This is what is there. This area you have to calculate, right? So this area you need to calculate, you know. So how to calculate this area? That is given by integration of this curve y. Area is given by integral y dx, and integration limit of integration is x is equal to 1 to x is equal to 3, and that further can be written as 1 to 3. Y is what? 3x plus 4 into dx. So we can conclude it like integration of 3x is 3x square by 2, and integration of 4x is 4. So that is 1, 2, 3. So if I put here value of 3, this is 3 square 9 into 3, 27 by 2, 27 by 2 plus 4 minus, if I put 1, 4, 3 is 12. Minus, if I'll put here 1, then this will be 3 by 2 and plus 4. So what will happen? Indeed, 27 by 2 minus 3 by 2 is 24 by 2, that is 12, and 12 minus 4, that is 8. So 12 plus 8 is 20 square unit. Let me check it. How is it 20 or not? This is what this is. This is basically the distance between them is 2. Isn't it 1, 2, 3? And the length of this parallel sides is, if I put x is equal to 1, y is 7. So this coordinate must be 1 and 7. That is, this length is 7. And if I put x is equal to 3, 3, 3 is 9, and 4, 12. So this is 13, right now? So this point is 3, 13. So this is a trapezium, na? So area of trapezium is what? Just check it. Let me check. Area of trapezium is sum of area of trapezium is 1 by 2 into sum of parallel sides, that is 13 plus 7 into height. Height is 2. 2 to cancel. 13 plus 7 is 20 square unit. So I hope you understood that what the application of integration is, that you can calculate the area, because it will form an similar figure which we know, that is this is a trapezium, so we can do it. But whenever there is no such a known figure is formed, then how can you do this? For example, if there is a question like find the area enclosed by curve x square is equal to 8y between x is equal to 1 and x is equal to 2, like this. So x square is equal to 8y. This is a parabola. Clearly, this is a parabola. You understood it. and you have learned this, that solution is what? So here, this is a parabola, right? Now, parabola is there, x square is equal to 8y is nothing else but a parabola. And x power even, so it is symmetrical about y axis, isn't it? So this is a symmetrical about y axis. And vertex is at origin, clearly, right? So we can write it like this, vertex is at origin. And parabola is like this. We have to find the area between these two. So we have to calculate the area enclosed between this parabola and between x-axis and between these two lines, right now. So how to calculate? This is not a known formula. This is not a trapezium, not a triangle, not a circle. So how can you do that? So in this way, here is integration. Definite integration will be applicable and useful because we are not able to find the area under this. But still, we can find the area y square is equal to 8x by help of integration. So, area of shaded region is given by integration of y dx. And what is limit of integration? 1 to 2. So, we can write this 1 to 2. And what is y? Y is x square by 8. So, x square by 8. We can put value of y from here, since x square is equal to 8y, so we can put y is equal to x square by 8. And what is integration of x square? That is x cube by 3. 8 is there, and limit of integration is 1 to 2. So this is 1 by 24. Limit of integration is x cube, that is 2, 1. So this will be 1 by 24, 2 cube minus 1 cube. 2 cube is 8. 1 cube is 1, 8 minus 1 is 7, 7 by 24 square unit. This will be the area of the curve. So, I think you understood that why the definite integration is applicable and how you use during the question and during the solutions of each and every applications which will be coming in physics. So, this is all about. I don't want to torture you by teaching more and more in definite integration and all. So this is what the useful application is required that I have discussed here. And hopefully you will revise all these things and you will be able to learn them, do it again and again. And if there is anything left, anything coming in between while I'm teaching the physics, and discuss then also, and I'll give the reference of each and everything what we have discussed earlier. So there is no more problems, and this is all about mathematical tool. Some people used to teach maxima and minima, but it is hardly used a maxima and minima in physics. Wherever it will be used, I tell you about the concept that. But let me write here definition that if maxima and minima is what? Say, find maxima and minima of any function is called local maxima or local minima. For example, if I have this and there is a graph of this, say, I have this graph, and if I write this, then this one is a point which is called as compared to the nearby points. Their value is here, this point is called minima, local minima, because in comparison to this, the value is maximum, more, and here is the least value. So this point, say x is equal to 0 is there, or x naught is there, this is called point of minima, you know, this point is called point of minima, local minima, say x is equal to 0. So this point is called point of local minima, point of local minima, right? And this point where the nearby neighborhood points has more value. So in comparison to this nearby points, the value is maximum here, right now. So we will write here, this is called point of local maxima. Right now, point of local maxima. So this point is called point of local maximum. This one is called, say x is equal to here, x is equal to 1, and this one is called point of local maximum. So this is called point of local maximum, right now. So I'll give you the concept as well, wherever it is required, and definitely I'll explain then. But try to understand that there is a point and how you can find it. If d2f double derivative y is a function, then at if d2y upon dx square, this is double derivative, is greater than 0 at x is equal to 0, x naught, then x is equal to x naught is point of local minima. And if d2y by dx2 is less than 0 at x is equal to 1, then x is equal to 1 is point of local maxima. Less than 0, then maxima, and greater than 0, then point of minima, local minima. So this is all which is required for maxima and minima, that we will discuss whenever it is required. Till then, I hope you enjoyed this class, and God bless you. Keep watching, and don't forget to subscribe this channel. Thank you very much. God bless.